What's up? So today we're in a different scenery. We're in my bathroom because I am going to step by step, as beautiful Kourtney Kardashian did in her new Vogue Beauty Secrets video. I will link a little clip right here.
Hi, it's Kourtney Kardashian. First, I'm gonna start by doing my morning skincare routine and my makeup look for when I do my own makeup. And I do really simple makeup. So I'm gonna show you how I do that.
By the way, if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe, join the Glam Fam. And if you already are subscribed, you know I love you. Don't forget to hit that post notification bell so you always know when I upload another video. Without any further ado, we're gonna insert my intro right now. Let's do this.
I just wanna show you all, I don't wanna do you wrong. Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the flies of them all?
Okay, so in the video, the first thing she did was she started with a homemade mud mask. Unfortunately, I don't have any of those ingredients, so I'm going in with the Glam Glow mud mask, and I never have applied my mud mask with a fan brush, but I'm gonna try. But I am gonna insert a clip because she did talk about in her video how Kim made her do a peel-off mask that was extremely painful and tight. So right now, I'm gonna insert a little clip of me doing a peel-off mask that literally took every hair off my face. So we're gonna insert that for giggles right now.
Really tight, it's just squeezing. It's a little bit painful, but I'm sure it's gonna be more painful to take it off.
This thing hurts. I can't bear, I'm Italian. I have like a beard and a mustache.
Okay, so let's see. I can't.
Here, let's see. I can't do the sides. There's too many hairs.
Okay, so basically the problem is that even though you take it off, like let's say you get it off, it still hurts. It still really hurts. Look at that. Okay, there's like major tingling in my face. I have like pieces of skin missing. I look worse than before I started.
I'm just gonna start with my fingers because this is a really awesome face mask. My skincare at night, but I mean, for the sake of the video, she did say it was her morning skincare routine. This necessarily wouldn't be my morning. I'm gonna go on my forehead like she did because I don't have any problems on my forehead. I don't think I've ever had a dot on my forehead in my life. I'm gonna spread it around with this fan brush just because that's exactly what she did. I have some drugstore options and affordable options as well as high-end, because some things I couldn't find a dupe in the drugstore. So while she was letting that mask sit, she said she doesn't like to waste any time. She started making her own homemade lip scrub. I would love to do that, but once again, I don't have it. So I'm going in with this Hemp's Sugarcane and Papaya. This is what I use to exfoliate my lips. It works really great, and it's got little sugar beads that taste amazing. And then all you have to do is just wipe it off. Wipe that off. Clean washcloth. And I am going to rinse the mask off my face and I'll be right back. I am back. I just want to mention that I love these little Vogue Beauty Secret quick videos. I did do a Kylie Jenner Vogue copy video back in the day. I will leave a link in the description bar below for your viewing pleasure. I had so much fun doing that video. And I also did Rihanna's. I'll leave that link as well. And I will also do put my real morning skincare routine, because this is just me doing Kourtney Kardashian's skincare routine and makeup. My technique is completely different, and I will leave my morning routine in the description bar below, but I am going to make an updated one. Here we go, we're gonna go to the next step. So the next thing she said she did was take her wipes. I would only use my wipes for removing makeup and then use like a cleanser. It's not about me, we're copying the video. So I obviously don't have like 100% organic fresh wipes. These are just Studio Selection oil-free pink grapefruit facial towelette. It says, with skin conditioning agents to help moisturize and soothe, suitable for blemish-prone skin, leaves skin feeling smooth and refreshed. And it says, compared to Neutrogena oil-free cleansing wipes, pink grapefruit. This comes in a 25 count. I paid $2.50. Happy that I am using a cloth right now, like one of these, just to get off any of that mask that I didn't get with the water. She used some kind of hydrochloronic serum. I'm going in with this Bare Minerals Skin Loving Longevity Vital Power Fusion Serum. This has hyaluronic acid on it as well. I mean, I'm 40 and I feel like my face is in great condition. I've never had work done on my face. And that's not saying she has at all. But I have never had like any retinol treatment or like any kind of like anything. I don't even know if it's called retinal treatment. Isn't retinal your eyes?
You are so dumb. You are really dumb, for real.
I don't know. Then she said her next step was spray. You can spray with a water. Like Evian water is a wonderful way to spray and hydrate your skin. But I am going in with the Mario Badescu skincare spray. Now I am gonna tell you right now, this is $12 at Ulta or Sephora, and this actually fixed my skin. But the thing I love about it is it not only takes away the powdery look of your makeup, but it's also skincare. So, and it's $12 for a big bottle that lasts you. It smells very good. And if you're definitely if you have dry skin, it's unreal. It's amazing. She went in with some oil. She went in with some all natural oil. I am gonna go in with the Versace 24 karat rose gold drops. I'm just gonna take it on the dropper. You can see that the gold is in there. Rub it with my clean hands. Remember, whenever you do skincare, I know this is the obvious, but make sure you wash your hands before doing anything. Go upwards. Because if you go upwards, you're less likely to get wrinkles. Big, big thing I wanna talk about. She talked about sunblock moisturizer. This is the Sephora Cream Hydrating Instant Moisture with Sunscreen. It's 25 SPF. This is one of the only sunscreens that doesn't break me out. And this is such a good moisturizer as well. So I'm going to put this into my skin. Get no flashback. This is awesome. I'm going with the Tarte Amazonian Clay because I legit don't own a organic or skin safe scale foundation, but I am gonna go in with this. She likes to put it on with her hands. I hate putting foundation on with my hands. It is one of my cringy pet peeves ever. I just don't like it, but I'm doing it for the sake of the video. I just don't like the feeling of foundation on my hands. I don't know, it's cringy. So this is the Amazonian Clay. Okay, I definitely have to clean this foundation on my hands or I'm gonna go nuts. She went straight in with concealer and then she like didn't set her face until the end. Which I'm like thinking to myself, doesn't that concealer crease? But you know, who knows? She gets her makeup, she said it, mostly professionally done. Video, she said that she hates doing her own makeup. I swear to you, doing my own makeup is what keeps me sane and peaceful day in and day out and doing videos with you guys. I'm gonna go in with this It Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye Illuminating Concealer. But this like kind of has the same thing. It's really brightening. She said she applies it with her fingers and then goes in with a small beauty blender. So one of these guys. This is not a beauty blender, a Real Techniques mini sponge. What I loved is what's about to come next. So she didn't set it right away. So that like makes me crazy because I just want to throw some powder on it right now. But that's okay. She went straight into bronzer and she was talking about how she just uses a bronzer and just instead of contouring, she like puts it all over her face. Like literally she was doing that. And I'm cool with that. I mean, it's not contour, so it's fine. She doesn't use blush when she's doing her own makeup. It's just so crazy. When you do a different somebody else's technique, it's so different. It feels so weird. Like, I would never do my eyebrows last. The bronzer, and the same brush that she used for her eyelids, because she says she's the same bronzer for her face, her eyelids. So let's do that real quick while we're at it. Okay, and then she used the same brush. Now, I'm using a Morphe M200. I don't know what she used. That she used for her lids and she went down her nose. Like, just like that. That's all she did. Just a little something. This is super cool. This is the idea that I like that we're about to get into. Except she used the KKW contour stick. I have to use the NYX contour stick because I don't have the KKW contour stick. But she says instead of putting it straight on her face, she goes right on her hand and puts a lot. And she takes a brush. She did cream after powder. And then she just contours a little bit on her cheekbones. And if she's feeling extra, right on her forehead. Was so excited to show you that step if you haven't seen the Vogue video already. Because that's kind of cool, you know? It makes it more natural looking. You see, I'm loving that. Because I can see, you guys can't really see, I'll take you outside. But it literally looks much more natural. So I might do that from now on. That part I might copy. She took some Laura Mercier, which I happen to have. I put a little bit on the lid. And she took her beauty blender, Eco Tools beauty sponge. And she just patted her face wherever she had shine. Make sure you watch that video. I'm gonna leave the link to that whole video in the description bar below as well. So you guys can watch it if you haven't seen it, which you probably have. She went in with lashes next and she curled her lashes. This is I don't even know where I got this from. And I'm just gonna curl my lashes. I never curl my lashes. I'm always afraid I'm gonna clip myself. Okay, so curling the lashes, she went in with the Lamb comb. I'm going in with the Marc Jacobs mascara. And then she used Dolce K by Kylie Cosmetics. I do happen to have that right here. I'm going to, she said she does overline her lips, in fact. So I am gonna overline my lips. Now I'm gonna go in with the KKW lipstick in Classic Nude 1. And she puts it on like this. Then she took her finger and she moved it around. It looks good, it looks good. I liked her lip color better. So definitely watch her video. She did highlighter next because brows were last. So she says she uses a little luminizer. I couldn't really catch if she used a powder or cream. So I am gonna go in with two things just to be safe. I'm going with the Perricone MD No Highlighter Highlighter. This is great for all of you beautiful women and men that love to just have a natural look. And she just says she puts it right here. So that's where I'm going to put it. I'm going to put three little tiny dots right on the highest point. I usually go on here. She says she does not like that whole beaming highlight and contour. And I'm just going to, just like she did, tap it in gently with my finger. Can you guys see that glow? It's very subtle, but very beautiful. This Perricone MD doesn't settle into your fine line. I'm just going to go into the lid of this Wet n Wild I'm So Lit 396A loose highlighter, and I'm gonna put just a tad, and I'm just gonna go. All right, I'm gonna go in with this e.l.f. brow pencil. I have raved about this pencil. I don't even want to talk about it again because I literally have told everybody and their mother, random people in the grocery store, I'm like,
you need to get this pencil.
And she had like no shape. She says she doesn't do an arch or. But you guys, this brow pencil is just incredible. So these are the brows completed. If my daughter was doing my makeup, these are the kind of brows she would definitely put on me. She likes a thinner, more calmed down brow. I like a more thicker, fleeky brow. We are done. We have completed the entire mission. This is the final look. I will do an update outside to show you what it looks like for real, under real lighting. I want to spray my face. I always spray my face when I'm done with my makeup. So yeah, that's the only thing, but I'm gonna stay true to the video and I'm gonna keep this makeup just like this without putting a setting spray. So there's a lot of great things I learned from Courtney. Here's a much better area to get a good idea. It's right by the window. But this looks, I love the contour. That's the best part. My skin looks kind of natural, clean. You know, only needles can fix this. Or a better night's sleep. Anyways, I love you guys so much. I hope you enjoyed my video. And I will see you in the next one. Don't forget to subscribe and peace. That skin though is so glowy without any highlighter. Like, hey, like I'm the Tin Man. Don't forget to follow me on Snapchat and Instagram. It's a good time. Trust me. All right. I love you. Bye.